I'm marking. Just gonna do this in really weird order. Just looking at my sketch that I have, trying to figure it out. Just gonna lay some fast brushes around first and see how I should move them. I want the lower floor here. Tennis. To get more water soon. Just have one glass. Half empty. Or half full. Yeah. It's the classic outlook of life question. That's the way to cheat it. How big? How big of a room do I want here? It's a good question. Mm-hmm. Oh, this is gonna be a really cool angle. Maybe I need to make the windows a little bit thinner, so it's a bigger angle that you can get. Well, that can be changed later, I guess. This is where you would have the grenade launcher, I think. Somewhere around here. Spam the railgun. I'm still using the old procs. That were the dev folders, but it's whatever. Works. gonna have like a cool route for the rocket launcher where you can just jump up for the mega health if you want. This is probably where you have an angle to the railgun as well. And the red armor, of course. Yeah, this area needs to be really low, so maybe long stairs or a lift. This is probably too long for a staircase, I'm not sure. Kinda awkward to fight in a place like this. Maybe I should block that off. another window. I'll get back to this room later. I'm not sure what I want to do here. It's just open, and maybe I'll open paths somewhere here. Maybe to the railgun. Or to upper floors. I need to make this red armor accessible. I think you can just jump over here. Up. Hi DJ. I finally had enough energy to start mapping. I wanted to map so badly yesterday, but I just... my brain didn't work. Should be fine. It's getting awfully close to the floor. I just need to go lower. Yeah. Something like this, maybe. Did I have planned here? Maybe rotary shotgun in this corner? just constantly glancing over my sketch that I have drawn on paper. And I'm already troubled with the grid settings because I'm making some different choices here. Need to adapt. I think I want a hole here for extra spamming. Be like that for now. Yeah, this is gonna be perfect. This room is gonna have so many locations that you can shoot, especially with this grenade launch. If you're making... What? If you were making an AI image, what words would you use as its prompt? Let me think for a moment. How about the Shambler with 37 rocket launchers? Specifically 37 rocket launchers. Still unsure which power up I should have here. Maybe haste, if not quake, quad damage. Gonna be a placeholder for now. It's kind of misaligned. I have to move a little bit. How would I do this part now? Maybe I'll just add a room. Hi, Becca. Welcome to the epic Quake Mapping stream. This is my first time trying to stream properly the mapping process. So I'm doing a very little, like, effort here. I'm just gonna make a block up. Yeah, I think the idea is to get this for episode 3. Just gonna do the deathmatch part first. And then later on add the single player stuff. I'm actually gonna give this away for arting process to someone else on the team. This is fine. This will work. Yeah, it's so easy to just add brushes and add 3D floors. You don't have to do any hacking that you have to do in Quake. I mean, in Doom. This is gonna be like a door that opens. I'll adjust the numbers later. It's not that interesting right now to add the functioning. And the button for that would be up here. Let's see. Oh yeah, horizontally moving platforms as well, yeah. Yeah, I know. It's pretty painful. I think I need to have a weapon here as well. Be kinda nice. Or maybe not. Thinking out loud is fun. I was thinking that I was gonna say something cool, but I didn't. Yeah. I'll make this functioning for fun. I'll make the door as well. After that, I can just copy paste it over and over again. That should be fun. Oh yeah, this lift as well. Maybe 4 is enough for the lift to return. Hope so. I'm doing everything so inefficiently. It'd be kinda cool to have some slime on the bottom floor as well, but not sure how to implement it here. I don't wanna have it right below the trapdoor. It'd be kinda silly. Just a random pool here, be kind of nice. I'm only missing this side. Wanna have an upper floor here, which connects to the railgun as well. Oops, I almost made a big mistake. Just getting too gimmicky. Thank you. Probably a lift here. Maybe swap these for now. It's easier to see the door opening when you hit the button on this room. I want to see if this is playable in any sense. There we go. Where's the button? It's inside the wall, isn't it? All the entities are gone. Oh, am I running this on a wrong thing? I guess I am. Oh no, it's a DM. I'm dumb. There we go. Sounds pretty low. Can't quite get the angle on the rail. Too high. Guess you can try to do that. I think I need to place another yellow armor on the other side of the map as well. Otherwise you can just get the mega and the red armor and the yellow armor here so easily. When you get the quad, you can shoot someone if they're camping on the red armor. Kinda like this already. I hope I make the rest of the map as good as this. Need to figure out what I'm gonna add here. Oh yeah, you can totally just push the lift up and then drop down for the railgun. That's also a nice function. Around effect from the world. Interesting. Probably a good idea to clip the window so you can jump through them. Maybe. I mean, not clip, but add some kind of visual thing there that is blocking the player. Still not sure about that. Maybe it's fine. Risky movement up to the mega hell. Huh. you could totally just rocket jump from there to red armor as well. Or right below as well. I'm at the phase where I'm just walking around and jumping on the block out that I've made. It's gonna take a while until I get back to the mapping phase. This is like what all the mappers do. Just wanna move around your map that you've made. I'll be right back. I need a short break. Okay. Now this side room. How do I do this? Maybe I can go wider. That's probably a good idea. Like this, maybe? why would I keep this? It's probably a good idea to do like this. Have something here. Yeah, it's almost done. How long has it been? Like, hour and a half? It's like almost complete. There's like not much to add. Little bit here on this side. And maybe a bath that goes around here on this upper floor. And then it's probably done. Just need to make walls and think about what to have there, but yeah. Maybe a teleport here, if I can come up with some good idea where to teleport. Or maybe a lookout over this area, where the rotary shotgun is. Yeah, maybe I'll just try to keep it very simple on this side. Not add too much here. Probably have a green armor here on the low grounds. There's so many different paths you can take from here when you get the armor. Nice. It's kind of strange, probably. When no one else is on and it's only me talking, you automatically think about that. Like awkward point here. Yeah, there's like 0 point connection there. Should this be just a yellow armor, maybe? It's quite far away from the red armor. Can always change them. I'm like really hard trying to think how to balance the armor positions. It's really fun to do. Or maybe this could be LG. Then if someone drops on you from these spots, you can just chaff them away. The rocket here. I think you can use this ramp to jump up as well. that the easier route is to teleport. Oh, you recorded your own vocals in this? Vocals and vocals, noises rather. That's cool. Trying to get some weapon placements in. Thinking about where they should be. And this is perfect placement for the regular nail gun. No one will want to pick this up. Just there. Exists. Hi, Corinne. I've been busy. Basically, 1 hour and 40 minutes of work making a deathmatch layout. Trying to come up with some cool ideas for the railgun usage and angles. Only one more thing to do here, adding a path that leads from this area over there, and then I'm gonna look what I can change. There's like some stupid areas that I need to reconsider. And adding more visual blockers, of course. I'm sure the line of sights are pretty weird when I add the walls. And I'm still thinking if I should have two rocket launchers in the map, or just one. Because in Dwell we add so many new weapons and stuff, it's kind of redundant to have two rocket launchers, I guess. It's gonna be pretty empty on this side. I wonder if this is gonna feel good. That feels weird. Placement for the red, I mean the green armor. So hard to decide. Maybe I could have one here over the mega. Get another useless nail gun there. And then there's of course the Berserk power-up that I could place somewhere. Thank you. Yeah, I think size-wise this is pretty good now. Doesn't need to be bigger than this. I think I'll just need to roam around it a bit and see how it feels. Totally can jump them. Yeah, there's a lot of walls that I have not placed, like here, this area, this is wall, walls here. This is a drop down though. I was thinking about having overlook here. And walls here. All of these need to be walled. Can you like visualize it already, how this is going to be when I add the walls? There's not a good grenade angle there to shoot over here. I guess I need to add wall there, so... Can't really snipe to the yellow arm. Oh, you can totally shoot the yellow armor from here. Unless I make the ceiling really low. Teleport is really fast way to get to the mega if you're down there. You get the rocket launcher as well. Huh. This room though, this is really empty. I need to add something here. Still need to figure out like what to do. I could just connect it to the railgun there. Add a path, but I'm not sure then this area will be like really open. I guess it would make sense to have a door here. It's like a nice little intersection where you can look everywhere. This area is just a little bit barren as well. I don't know. Does it need to be connected a little bit better? A little bit better or something? Or I could have a path that goes up from there to the bursar. I got damage. Yeah, this is lockout layout for Dwelldm6. Yeah, I think I'll add the path here and see what I can do with that. And after that, I'm gonna add the walls so I can feel the map better. There's a lot of nice sniping angles on this map. Like, you can shoot up to the red armor over there, and the quad damage is here. Below. I like how sneaky this path is. You can just go around and hopefully outplay your opponent without making any sounds. There we can kind of like sneak to the red armor here. Little sniper hole. Huh. And you can also like drop down from that lift. You don't have to go up to the red armor. You can just pick up the rail and escape. I really like that lift idea. This was the first thing that I was thinking when I started making the map. Then you can of course shoot through the hole. Okay, back to mapping. But then the Berserk is on the way. That's a problem. Or I could just add it on bottom of the left, maybe. I'm not sure. It's adding so much empty space. Yeah, maybe I'll just add a teleport. That's probably a better idea. We can still have this corridor. Maybe. I don't know, maybe it's weird to have it have this at all. No one will get this shotgun. Really long sideline as well. There's already quite a few longish corridors. Yeah, maybe I'll just add one more there. No, there should be enough weapons. Adding walls is just a tedious process. still so much detail to be added here. You can take the teleport to go all the way around back here, which is nice. I really don't like this room. Like, desperately trying to come up with some ideas how this should be. Maybe these walls can be like an environment outside. Still quite a bit to go. I'll be happy if I get the sealed version of this done today. And then maybe later I will try to add more stuff and fix things that I don't like. This has been really, really fast process to make this. It seems to be, it's a pretty fine looking map. If I can just balance it right. Sometimes I just like adding random shapes. I don't know why I do this, but it's it's relaxing, I guess. Yeah, this room has some problems. This is a bit blocky room as well. Damn it. Yeah, I'm just missing the low grounds. Almost there. It's a bit tricky to do walls on this area. Getting confused by these floors up above. Phew, okay, that's all the walls done. Just need to add the top ceiling. It's a fairly compact map. Compact. Not combat. Oh yeah, spawning points. Well, single player doesn't matter right now. Be so mean to place one spawn point here, but it's kind of messy. Don't wanna do that. Okay, now the next question probably is where am I gonna place all the items, ammo pickups and the health pickups? Maybe this should be a spawn point. Makes sense. Same here. Maybe here. I think that's probably enough health. That's enough cells. Don't want to put too many because there's the lightning gun and the railgun both give ammo anyways. This might be it. I don't think I have more items to place anymore. There are like four good spawns for rocket launcher pickup. If you know what you're doing, I think that's fine. This is a bit empty. Oh, IOOD. Yeah, I made a pretty decent block out in what has been 3 hours. Yeah. It's looking pretty good. There are a couple rooms that I still want to maybe edit, but it is what it is. I think I'm about ready to test this again. Leaking. Oh, is it because I don't have any light entities? That's probably it. Just throw a couple randomly. Yeah, there we go. It's a bit dark because I don't have lights. Is this black? It's weird that it's... Oh yeah, it's some shader, so it doesn't take the lighting. It's pretty nice. I like it. Did I even add another green armor somewhere? Did I forget? Oh no, it's here, right next to the mega. Maybe it should be easier to get it. Like, probably next somewhere around this rocket launcher. Or here in this room, in this box. Oh, the yellow armor is up there. Hmm. Berserk power-up is gonna be pretty useful on these small corridors. We want to try to get some axe kills. Reflect. Yeah, this is Dwelldm6 lockout layout that I'm planning. Try to think many possible angles and stuff that you can do. Like this rocket launcher placement is right below the mega health, so you can just rocket jump. There's a railgun down there with this lift. Shoot down there. And it takes you to the red armor up here. Or you can do the reverse where you get the railgun here, someone presses the button, you can just shoot their ass from below. This room is a little bit blocky, and I don't know exactly if this is like good, but it's for the haste power up anyways. Yeah, it will have the single player as well once it's arted and everything. Just have to think about how the single player progression will go. This is pretty complicated layout for single player. There's a lot of tunnels and stuff. The quad is here and you have to engage. Well, it's close enough. You can shoot through that hole if you position yourself right. Yeah, this is good enough. Uh-huh. I think this should be pretty fun for small player deathmatch free for all. It's not too big for size. This is pretty cool angle to shoot the yellow armor at the below. Jump from the pickups to here. From here you can hit the rocket launcher that is all the way across there. Yeah, I think the phase one is done. I'll add polish later. What? I don't have my no clip bind? Oh, never mind. It's because it's in deathmatch. It's a fairly decent size. Oh, I'm getting kind of tired. So much brain power spent making this. Three hours and 30 minutes. Pure mapping. Except one break. Okay, I think I'm done. I'm gonna look if anyone's streaming something cool and rate them. I guess Comfy will do. This May playthrough is still going. See you around. Until next time. Bye bye.